Okay guys, so it is Vlogmas day 7. I'm currently on my way to meet with a woman named Gabriella, and she, I don't even know what it's necessarily called. It's like a deep tissue sports massage thing. Hi. Thanks, Mom. Physical therapy, I don't even know what it's called, but I'm gonna take you guys along with that because I think it'll be very interesting, especially if you're a dancer, to like see what we do. Okay guys, so this is Gabriella and she's gonna tell you a little bit about what we're doing today.
Okay, what I'm doing with Tessa, it's what I do most with dancers that have issues on the muscles, tight muscles, pain around the hips, all that, you know, yucky stuff around your body that doesn't allow you to go full into your extensions.
Okay,
so what I'm doing is I'm releasing the fascia.
It's painful.
It is painful. But trust me, it's so worth it. At the end, it's so worth it.
We're gonna focus on probably my hip mostly because that's the messed up part. And yeah, it hurts really bad, but it's really, really good after. Like the day after, your muscles feel so much more like relaxed.
Oh yeah, and what it creates is just creates a space in between your joints and your muscles. That's why that nice elongated,
yeah,
you know,
just like
lines,
all the, like,
they come
out and like lets them release.
And the only way you can do that is absolutely releasing the fascia. There's no other way. So, you can stretch whatever you want, but it's not gonna happen the way it will happen after my magic hands.
Awesome. Okay, let's get started.
Okay.
So pretty much the idea behind that is I have some hip issues, especially in my right hip. The issues stem from just too much extra tension in my hip, just from like overuse and dance and all that stuff. So she pretty much, what she does is just digs really deep into the muscles while stretching them, and she really releases the tension and just lets my and it allows my muscles to just really like release all the tension and become as lengthened as possible. So it's the best thing ever. Like I always feel such better results, especially the day after when I'm in class, especially ballet or something. It just feels so much better. Just gets like all the gross tension out. The days that I do work with her, I try to not exercise or dance afterwards so that your body gets the best capable results. You're not supposed to, so I try not to. So today I'm not going to. Everyone is driving so slow. And coming to you from a bathroom, here is my outfit. I told you guys I'd show you, so here you go. I just have this jacket on because it's cold out, a black tank top, and then I have a pair of black leggings, and yeah. Guys, you should go watch Vlogmas Day 6. Okay guys, so I edited the video. You guys should definitely watch that video. I'll put the link to it above. Me and my mom go grocery shopping. We give you guys some health tricks and just like a day in the life vlog, all that good stuff. I need to stop touching my hair when I talk. I don't know, it's like the awkward thing I do, you know, when you're talking to a camera. But either way guys, I'm going to head into the grocery store, even though I was just at the grocery store yesterday, and I'm going to get stuff to make paleo gingerbread cookies. I'm touching my hair again.
Okay guys, so I just got home. I went into the grocery store and they had no coconut sugar, which is like a weird thing I would think to sell out of. But yeah, so like all paleo cookie recipes require coconut sugar, so I could not make anything. So instead, I decided I will just show you guys my nighttime skincare routine because I need content, and that's content. So the first thing I use is I wash my face with this Garnier Skin Control soap. I have like none left. I'll have all the products linked down below. Once I'm done washing my face, I go in and I use this micellar Garnier water, and I just put it on a cotton ball. Just put it on a cotton ball and then I just go all over my face. Now this is just to get like off any extra makeup and all that stuff. Now I only use this if I had a lot of makeup on that day. Like only if I use foundation. If I don't use foundation, I just wash my face. I try to do as little to my skin as possible just because I have really sensitive skin, so I don't want to dry it out. They say you don't need to wash this stuff off, but I still wash it off. Just rinse it off with some water. Then after that, I go in with this. Now this is actually my favorite product. If I had to choose one skincare product that I think makes the biggest difference in my skin, it is definitely this stuff. So I just assembly, put it all over my face. Now this stuff is so light and it's oil-free, so it doesn't make you like all gross and slimy, which I really, really love. And yeah, guys, that is quite literally all I do. The main key thing I think to skin, or at least what I personally think, is I don't think it's even necessarily what products you're using. Like, of course that matters, but I think it's just what you're eating, because like I will be using the same products and I'll be eating crappy, my skin will be breaking out completely, and then I will be using the same products eating good and my skin will be perfect. So just eat clean and you're more likely to have good skin, or at least that's my philosophy behind it. Yeah guys, this was the end of today's video. I know it wasn't that eventful, but hey, it's Vlogmas. I can't do something crazy every day. At least I want to, but I can't. So, yeah guys, I hope you enjoyed today's video. Don't forget about the giveaway contest. I'll have all the information to that linked in the description bar. And yeah guys, I love you all, and I will see you for Vlogmas day 8 tomorrow.